Hello and welcome back to Iran Daily Newsfeed. Let's have a look at today's news. Azerbaijan has closed an office and a mosque, a place known as Husseiniyya, where the martyrdom of Shiite-lmam Hossein is mourned for, the theater of passion place in its capital, Baku. IRGC-run Tasnim News confirmed the mosque and representative office of Seyyed Ali Akbar Ojaghnejad, representative of Supreme Leader of Ali Khamenei, who held the post since 1996 in Baku, was sealed and closed today by order of the authorities of the Republic of Azerbaijan. The Azerbaijani authorities have ordered to shut and seal the office and Husseiniyya linked to the Islamic Republic Supreme Leader Ali Khamenei just days after Tehran held military exercises close to the two countries' common borders. However, Azerbaijan's Interior Ministry said in a statement, the cause for the closure, which also affected other indoor spaces, was a surge in coronavirus infections, but experts described the reason for the act as political preparation and say the malignant and provocative actions by the Islamic Republic in the region have led Baku to take such decision. Since the revolutionaries took power in Iran, Tehran has decided to work harder to enhance its revolutionary image abroad so that it would export its revolution. The Islamic regime uses unofficial and semi-official activities in the flag of Islamic and Shiite culture to do so. Ayatollahs have run a large number of Islamic centers and mosques throughout the world that disseminate their fundamentalist ideology and generate grassroots support for their radical foreign policy. According to the think tanks that monitor Tehran's behavior, the centers provide the regime with a recruiting pool for the Revolutionary Guards, Quds Force, or other regime's institution responsible for terrorism or military activities abroad. The Islamic Revolutionary Guard Corps has warned the Iraqi Kurdistan regional governments again. The commander-in-chief, Yahya Rahim Safavi, who serves as the assistant and advisor to Ali Khamenei, the aged terrorist general, told the state-run Defa press, "We have informed the Iraqi Kurdish regional government that there should be no armed group in areas under their control countering the Islamic Republic." Previously, another IRGC commander, Mohammad Pakpour, warned Iraq that Tehran will not tolerate militants in north of the country. The top military commander warned the Islamic Republic will not tolerate the presence of anti-Tehran groups in the Iraqi Kurdistan region, threatening to take harsh actions against them. The Brigadier General, who holds the post of commander of the Islamic Revolutionary Guard Corps ground forces since 2009, has urged both the Iraqi government and the Kurdistan regional government to expel the militia groups out of northern Iraq. Otherwise, he said, the IRGC will attack the bases of the groups on Iraqi soil. By criticizing water consumption management, the chief of the Water and Sewerage Department of Tehran province has warned about water shortages in the Iranian capital. He says by continuing the current situation, Tehran may face water scarcity or unimaginable events in the coming future. Dr. Norizi emphasized that the issue of water shortage in Tehran is more important than air pollution in the largest metropolis of Iran. PEN America has honored three imprisoned Iranian writers, Bakhtash Abtin, Kayvan Bajan, and Reza Khandan Mahabadi, on Tuesday at its annual gala that featured actors Judy Foster and Awkwafina. Freedom of expression nonprofit PEN America said they are three celebrated writers who have been imprisoned by the Iranian authorities for their writing, their defense of free expression, and their peaceful opposition to state censorship. Previously in a letter, the New York-based nonprofit organization also wrote a letter which was signed by dozens of high-profile writers and artistic figures, including Nobel laureate J.M. Coetzee, Orhan Pamuk, Meryl Streep, Alec Baldwin, Alice Sebold, Colm Tobin, and the cartoonist Art Spiegelman, calling on the Islamic Republic to acquit and release the imprisoned Iranian writers. The Facebook whistleblower Francis Hagen has told Congress that China and Islamic Republic are using the social media platform to gather information on enemies and that understaffing of the site's counter-espionage team is a threat to US national security. However, Facebook is banned in both China and Iran, but the 37-year-old data engineer who quit Facebook in May and was the source of the bombshell Wall Street Journal expose into the company's practices declared that Beijing and Tehran use the social network to spy on the enemies. And that was all for today. I'm Kate, and thank you for the privilege of your time.